Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Newbury Racecourse here on Saturday. It's the 13th of June, 2020. Gonna look at the stakes races on the program from Newbury, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKit5 for more selections for racecourses around the world, and also join me this upcoming Tuesday for the beginning of Royal Ascot. I have previews and selection for Tuesday's card and all the other cards throughout the week from Royal Ascot, so go check that out. But let's get to the stakes action here on this Saturday card. From Newbury, we'll be looking at races 5, 6, and 7, the 225, the 3 o'clock, and the 335. The fifth race, 225, it is the Mason Bet at Newbury Phillies Stakes. It's a Phillies listed stakes for Class 1 horses, going for a purse of $34,000, race for 3-year-olds and upwards. Phillies mares only. A dozen horses are going 1,400 meters or 7 furlongs on the turf course. My top selection, I'm going to take the 4-horse Fox Trot Lady. We'll go 4-7-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 4-7-5 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection of 4-horse Fox Trot Lady. 5-year-old mare by Fox Wedge. David Probert's on this one for Andrew Balding. The horse's most recent outing came the 3rd of June at Kempton, 1 mile in the Snowdrop Stakes, and the horse finished fourth by 2 lengths there, and she just kind of stalked all the way around the race course, a little bit wide, and she just couldn't get the good turn of foot. Coming here second off the break, I think she could win here. I believe I did back her last time out, by the way, Kempton. Let's go check the notes. Two backs here on the 27th of September at Newmarket, 1 mile in the in the Rosemary Stakes, and she finished 6 by 1¾ lengths there, and she just kind of hit the wall late. That just couldn't stay the trip there. And then before that, Doncaster, 7 furlongs in the Group 3 Skeptree Stakes. She finished 5th by 3 lengths, and that particular afternoon, she was just never really getting into it. I don't know if she liked Doncaster. It wasn't her day to win. I think today, getting a little bit of a given the ground should really suit her well, coming back here. But it's been a while since she had a given the ground. But if you look at her races last summer, she was facing some very tough horses. This listed race isn't as tough as, say, the Oak Tree Stakes, the Summer Stakes at York. Cutting back in trip, second off the break at 5-1, I think she has a massive shot, so let's use her. So to recount my selection for the 225, the fifth race from Newbury, it's the Mason Bet at Newbury Stakes. Gonna use the 4-horse Foxtrot Lady. We'll go 4-7-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. The sixth race to 3 o'clock from Newbury. It is the British Stallion Stud Mason Bet Abingdon Stakes. It's listed stakes for Class 1 horses, going for a purse $40,500. Race for 3-year-old fillies, which are EBF eligible. 9 horses are going 2,000 meters or a mile quarter in this Oaks prep. My top selection, I'm going to go with the 4-horse here, Franconia. I'm going to go 4-3-1 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 4-3-1 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection 4-horse Franconia. Jedmon owned, John Gazin trains, and La Franco de Torre gets to mount. The horse's most recent outing and only outing came the 8th of November at Chelmsford. 7 furlongs on the poly track and a Class 4 Phillies novice. And that particular afternoon, she finished 2nd by a neck. She stalked all the way around the race course. She just couldn't hold on late, but she ran a terrific race off the break. Now, they probably wanted another race under her belt for the season, but, everything this year is basically, weird. It doesn't even make sense. But coming here against winner stakes quality horses for the first time, they must really think highly of her to face these horses. Mile quarter trip should suit her well. She's drawn on the inside. She has some tact. She gets a little bit closer to the front, which I think is going to be very good. At 5-1, I think she is going to be an improver here, so we'll use her. The 3-horse Domino Darling, another horse that I think could really be improving. Also, staying closer on this turf course shouldn't be half bad. She went on very sloppy ground at Doncaster back in October very, very nicely. Another horse to a mile quarter, even longer in the future, should really suit her well. 9-5, I think she could win. So this kind of race on the play spot, you want to go a little deeper. But to recap my selection for the 6th, the 3 o'clock for Newbury, it's the Abingdon Stakes. Let's take the 4-horse Franconia. We'll also give kudos to the 3-horse Domino Darling, and we'll go 4-3-1 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. Now, today's 7th race feature on the program, originally scheduled for Epsom last Saturday, but with the everything getting weird, it got moved here to Newbury. The 7th race at 3:35, it's the Group 3 Diomed Stakes. It's a Group 3 race for Class 1 horses, going for a purse $49,000, race for 3-year-olds and upwards. 9 horses are going the 1,600-meter journey or 1 mile on the turf course. Usually this race run at the extended mile, at the mile 16th, but so they're cutting it back at a 16th of a mile to a mile down the straightaway. But with that being said, my top selection, I like the 4-horse again, Zaki. We'll go 4-7-2 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. trifecta. 472 Tricast Trifecta. Top selection of four horse Zaki. This 5-year-old gelding by Laurent DeSemino. Ryan Moore's on this one for Sir Michael Stout. The horse's most recent outing came the 8th of December at Sha Tin in Hong Kong, and the Group 1 Hong Kong Mile. And the horse finished 8th by 4.5 lengths there and really just had nothing. And when the British horses go to Hong Kong, they don't particularly run well, especially in the mile. It just wasn't the day to win. Coming to a realistic spot today, I think he's loaded. Two back at Newmarket on the 27th of September, 1 mile in the Joel Stakes. Finished 3rd by 8.25 lengths by Ben Battle, who ran a terrific race. This horse was just with him early on, kind of hit the wall late. It was at the end of a very tough campaign there. And then before that, in the Strensale Stakes at York over the 1800 on the mile, the horse went by neck, a little all out that day, but you know, he got the job done late, and he wanted to run early on. Ryan Moore did not want to let the horse run that day, but coming here to Newbury shouldn't be a problem. Actually won this race very nicely at Epsom, by the way, last season, and after that had a terrific place in the Summer Mile. Coming here off the break, I think he could win against these horses, so let's use him. Second likeliest winner is 7 horse King Comedy. Martin Harley's on this one for John Gazin. Most recently in the QE2 Stakes at Ascot on Champions Day, the horse ran horribly, finishing 13th by 19 lengths, a very waterlogged ground. The horse didn't like it. I like a good to stop, but not waterlogged like it was at Ascot. You know, before that, placed in Joel Stakes bound Ben Battle, and then the Gedmon International just couldn't stay with him, but ran a terrific race in St. James Palace over at Ascot back last June. Another horse to a mile. I think he's loaded, so let's use him also on the ticket. So to recap my selection for the 335, the featured 7th race from Newbury, it's the Group 3 Diomed Stakes. Let's take as a top selection the four horse Zaki. Also use the 7 horse King of Comedy, and we'll go 472 in the Tricast Trifecta. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingCat5. Good luck, everybody.